So welcome everyone. So today I'm going to show you how to install Zabbix server. I know a lot of people who was like suffering for the installation and go for a lot of manuals. So I'm going to show you an easy way. So let's begin. I'm beginning with the update. Update first. So first, let's check our version. So it's Ubuntu 16. So let's begin with installation. No, no, a lot of people like apt-get install, but let's see. So let's install my SQL server. And here you wrote. So put your password and again put your password, whatever you want. I am gonna also put the commands in the description, so you have to, like, you don't need to do, just like copy paste and that's it. Wait a little bit until my SQL server is working. Zabbix is really good, it's open source and it's really good for monitoring. Can also teach you small tricks. Taking some time. Okay, now open door and it's already added. So next command and update. You can see here it's already added in Zabbix 3.2. bit. Okay. Well, Zabbix is like not like Nagios. Nagios, you have to configure everything from command line, but Zabbix, you can configure everything from the web interface. A lot of PHP. Okay, we are done now. So we're going from MySQL and minus u, which is your username, which is your root, and minus p, which is a password. Enter your password, what you entered, and here, copy this one here. So you create a database, which is Zabbix, and give all privileges. Zabbix, and if you can enter whatever you want, this is the default one, this is the default password, whatever you want. Zabbix, enter also your password, this is not a problem. And if so, well, so here we're going for user share doc slash Zabbix server. Make sure that this file is here. Make sure that this create SQL is here. So you copy this one here and enter, which is a password. This is a password, which is here also. Whatever you want. Zabbix is the default one. So you enter your database password. And it will take some time to create all the databases, all the tables inside the database. So it will take like in between 1 minute, 2 minutes max. So we have to wait until it creates all the tables in the Zabbix Где-то ведь. Also, to secure your database more secure, it already has two passwords. But for this one, for Zabbix database, you see here, create database Zabbix, which is you put the password Zabbix, and here also when we use this command, it's Zabbix, minus p, which is password, is Zabbix. You can put whatever you want. Your password also to make it more secure. It takes some time. It's creating a lot of tables, so gonna wait. This is gonna take some time. You can forward the video, but I'm gonna make it step by step, because if you lose one step, it's gonna break everything, so you don't have. So I'm gonna make it like you have to wait. Because we don't have to rush on this, because it's really complicated. Yes, and here we go. So let's check what's happening. So check our database. Check your password. So show databases. Yeah. So it's already here. So use Zabbix. And we use Zabbix. So show tables. And here all the tables is created. Make sure that everything is already here. All the tables here. So exit and let's have its configuration, but before we enter the configuration we have to do time it list. So check your time and we go to Apache. And here we go, yes, copy your name, time zone, I'm going for Apache here, and add this line, and here, and also here. Save it, and exit. Here Zabbix server, so Zabbix server configuration here, listening port should be listening only port, print it out, source IP you don't need it, this is not needed as well, debug label yes. Database host, database name, here Zabbix, database username, yes, we need it, password, we can put the database password here, as well, here, put your favorite password, but I put Zabbix, because this is a database password. Save your file, okay, and you do service Zabbix server, restart, you restart your server, and Apache, you restart, restarting your Apache. So you check your IP address here, copy your IP address, go for your web browser here, and slash Zabbix, and you're going for the installation here, and next step, everything is okay here, you're going to see everything is okay, because we changed the time already, so the time here. Here you see, so next, and here also your password, which is Zabbix, the default password, it will be saving. Also here, this is a host, which is a local host, and this is a port what we committed, we uncommitted, and here's the name also here, which is Zabbix, and here all your configuration, and next, and congratulations, you finish your installation. Okay, so this is a username and this is a password. Okay, so here's admin. Yeah, I got a little confused about this one. And we are in so Zabbix, you see Zabbix server is not running, you have to start your Zabbix server, which is service Zabbix server start. Check it here as well. Status. You see, it's active and running. And here, refresh your web page, and it's running. So this is the installation. It's really, really simple, and you can install it like we took like 10 minutes max. So don't rush in your configuration. Follow it step by step. You're gonna find everything in the configuration. Also, I put everything in the description, all the commands. If you need anything, you can also you can write any comment. I will help you also with anything. But for the next video, I'm gonna show you how to put the agent, how to run the agent, and how to configure the agent to monitoring your host. Thank you for watching, and have a good time.